Hey, welcome to day 23 of Advent of Code. So today's video is going to be a little bit different. It's not the same as before because I didn't actually write any code to solve today's challenge. By the way, if you're looking for day 22, it's not up yet. I have a working idea for the second half of day 22, but I haven't been able to put it together yet because it's quite tricky. And yeah, I haven't had time. So we're just going to skip ahead to day 23 today. So what I did was I did this entire challenge on pen and paper. It reminded me of those sliding puzzles that you used to play as a kid. And it didn't look that hard to do. So that's what I did. And when I say pen and paper, I mean Vim and keyboard. But doing it this way, it's very easy to miscount. And it's kind of hard to explain in a video, so I've put together a little program to do that for me that will count my score and let me move things around. The library I'm using to do this is called Turnbox Go. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Let's see. So when I look at this puzzle, my first thought is, actually, there wasn't even really a first thought. It was just, hey, let's just move some stuff out of the way. And then I want to get the C over to this B, so the B needs to move out of the way. We want to move the B out of the way, not the C out of the way, because C is more expensive to move, right? You want the C's and D's to just drop in as much as possible. But now the C has to get into here, so this D has to get out of the way. That's the minimum it needs to move. We get the C in, we get the D in, we get the B in, we get the other B in. D goes straight into where it wants to go, which is minimal. Drop the A in, drop the B in. This was the first thing I tried. So once I tried that, I counted my score and then I put it in and lo and behold, it was right. So that was my part one. That's literally all I did. Now part two was a little bit more tricky though, because when I put in part two and I tried moving things around, there are a couple of different things you could do in this case. Whoops. For example, you could move this A over here, but now this A could go here, like this, and then maybe this B goes over here, or something like this, right? There are a couple of things you could do. And maybe this A into here. Maybe this B into here, something like this, perhaps. And no matter what I tried to do, I couldn't get the answer. Every answer I tried, the website said it was too big. In fact, I think I might have messed this up. Yeah, this is actually not a working solution. So what I decided to do was actually, instead of working forwards and trying to get to the solution from here, because there were multiple paths, I decided to work backwards and go from the solution and try to work backwards to my initial state. And it turns out this way was actually a lot easier, for at least for my specific input. Because as you can see here, we need to get three D's into A. And the only way to get these D's into the A is if we move all the A's into the edges, like this. And then we drop the D's in. Once we drop the D's in, we need a B to cap it off, and there's no reason not to just get this B over. It's never going to be cheaper than that. Now we need to get two C's here into the D column. So we got to get this D out of the way. Move these C's in. And then we can finish this off because we drop an A into here and drop a D back on top. So that seems quite straightforward. And then from here, what we need to do is we need to get a C into the bottom of the B column. And remember, because B's are way cheaper to move than C's, what we want to do is clear out the B column to get the C in, that has to be the cheapest. And so there are only three places that the Bs can go that will still allow a C to move into that column, and that's these spots. Which means now we drop the C in. Now we need to drop a B in. This is the closest B, so we put this B in. We drop the other C in. There's that. Now we drop an A in, because that's the only A we can put into there. We drop a B into here. Now we need an A again. Oh, I moved up and down, so my score is going to be two bigger than it's supposed to be, but I'm not going to do it again. I accidentally pressed up down on my arrow keys, and I don't have an undo function. So this is going to look a little bad, but because I accidentally moved an A two spaces more, it's too, the score displayed in my terminal is two bigger than it's supposed to be. But yeah, that was my answer. And so maybe this one, if you put some, if you could put together something to help you count, but honestly, I didn't. I literally just went from here. What did I do? I started from the solution like this, and then I decided, and then I moved stuff, then I moved stuff again, and I moved stuff again, and then I started from the bottom and I counted back up my moves. So that was 60 to move to there, 58 to move to there, and so on. And I got to the same answer. It just goes to show that some of these challenges, you don't have to always code a solution. You can just use pen and paper and work something out. So that's all there is to this one, and that's really the video for today. So thanks for watching. Don't know if this was, I guess it was one insightful thing, which was you could do this challenge backwards or forwards, and your answer would still be the same. And that was really helpful for me to solve the second part. So maybe if you're coding up a solution, that could be helpful too. It might make your search tree smaller. So yeah, thanks for joining me, and I'll see you again next time.